Standing Tall. It's a podcast, but a good one.
The message from me would be just, you know, the strength that you don't know you have really comes out through adversity in life. Well, three paragliders.
How you doing? It's Madam Q here. Had a chat with Gene Decode, and the audio quality is a tiny bit less than I'm used to, just because had some issues with the computer and this and that. Today, recording this and editing the video, as in putting in footage and things like this, it's the 6th of November, Saturday. It's 7 o'clock at night in Sydney. When we recorded, it was 4 a.m. Sydney time. Apologies if I sound a bit tired in the interview. The other thing is, with a 3-second delay, there's going to be a lot of threes today. We keep talking over each other, and that's just because of passion. We enjoy what we're doing in our own way, and I love having Gene on, and I hope, anyway, that Gene likes talking to me, and we certainly do have a good flow, but there are those moments where we crash into each other. And when I'm listening to other people's podcasts and that happens, I'll sometimes go, "Damn it, host, get your stuff together. Come on." But I do it too, and I do it all the time. One finger pointing, three pointing back, as I have always said since the dawn of time. We're going to talk about today on the show more things that are a little bit more comical, fun, light energy. None of the doomsday stuff. Sorry, it doesn't float my boat, guys. It's easy to get sucked into that and think that the world's going to come crashing down and the sky is going to fall over your head and the firmament's going to, you know, twist you up into, you know, some kind of congealed intestine. No! We've got to think positive, people. We've got to lift our spirits up and up and up. And, we do that, even the lowest vibrational human will lift as well, you know. No one gets left behind. That's exactly why everyone is, you know, in this duality, and I certainly hope that this will pull people out of that and consider that what is reality and who set the measurement metric for you to measure from. The floors, the walls you walk, well, you don't walk through walls, do you? See, if you grew up and you didn't have anyone to tell you that you can't and you need builders to build houses, how would you know what you can and can't do with the physical reality we live within? So that is what they reference as kind of a matrix of sorts. And that matrix is everything we think, we think, we think, and we think, and we think, and we think. That's it. Stop thinking. Enjoy this. There's slideshows all throughout it, with some comical screenshots I've taken from my phone. I thought I'd just throw it in the video because it's capturing the year of 2021. And of course, 2020 being the year of hindsight, what a perfectly timed way to get a pandemic, you know, get everyone to think about how they have taken life for granted, and a beautiful, buoyant way of giving everyone an opportunity to look back going, 2020 hindsight, and life has never been more valuable. And the collective near-death experience humanity's gone through, it's better than World War III because there's less suffering. I know some people, and certainly it is not a great thing, okay? But we can't change it, we can't change. It is what it is at this point. So the only thing we have is the moment, and, you know, the last moment where I just clicked the last time, it's gone. It's gone. But together, we're going to manifest a new reality right now. Let's do it before we start with Gene. I command my spirit to bring me more source energy. I command my spirit to bring through more source energy. I command my spirit to bring through more source energy. Now try thinking. Enjoy the show.
Good morning, beautiful people of planet Earth. How are you? It's Matt MQ here. Hi, Gene. How are you doing?
I'm doing great, Matt.
Excellent, excellent. Oh, wow. We've made it to November 2021. I mean, my goodness, what an interesting year. It felt like the year that got kind of deleted from us, but also felt like the slowest
year just with anticipation, wondering and waiting to make sure that, oh, is everything going to be okay? I'm sure we've all gone through those ups and downs, the thrills and spills of life. And, yeah, certainly since we spoke last in June, it has felt like a duality for me of time going quick, time going really slow as well. Yeah, how have you been with the last 6 months? And I heard you had a bit of a wipeout for a while there with the, I'll call it the S word and the H word, and it doesn't end in IT, but it's close enough. How's that been going? It's certainly very real when that happens.
I'm doing great now, like all out on my own and doing great and working like crazy. I mean, busy beyond comprehension. We're in beta testing for the website for the Blessed for Service. So, man, that takes a lot of time. Always getting a website up. Oh, my goodness. Especially when you don't use a lot of off-the-shelf software. The web designer wrote all the apps. He's amazing. But it's like, wow, busy, busy, holy smoky. And then the lots of new coordinators coming on, especially in the U.S. So because we're getting inundated with lots of requests for the protocols because, you know, of what's going on with the mandates. And it's just really almost overwhelming. Barely have time to sleep and eat and shower and do my dailies, you know, do a little bit of work on the house here and there. It's like, wow, holy smoky. And, you know, fortunately for the kind people sending in donations, thank you, all of you. We're breaking even on the cost for developing the website. So we're breaking even. We're having to dip into the monies, I say, from the previous place I was, the donations that came in there from for me being there. But other than that, just busy like crazy, doing good. Beautiful fall out where I am. Fall colors, really nice. It was cold the first 2-3 days. The forecast was for snow all week. Now it's beautiful and sunny and warm. It was like, not a very good forecast, but I'm really glad you were wrong, because it's like, I get my doggies and go out and walk in the park and see the beautiful, and hardly anybody's out there anymore. And it's like, wow, this is really peaceful and nice.
Hopefully that doesn't become more common as the months tick by, that it's thinner and thinner out there in public.
It's just people are afraid to get out. And yeah, I keep a skirt of about, try to keep 30 feet. I did get a little flare up the beginning of this week and the end of last week, because I had to be out, our car had a airbag light, had to take the dealer and dropping it off. I had to be exposed to triple punctured people for a while. And it caused it to flare up. Like standing within 10 feet, it feels like I'm being hit by a needle gun. It's like, waggity, waggity, waggity. go out and wipe my neck down with a wet washcloth. And I get little tiny, literally what looks like little tiny needles off my neck. I'm like, well, that makes sense why it feels like that, because that is what it is. They're throwing needles at me. Holy moly. So, yeah, a little bit of stingy stuff from them. But, you know, with the Magellan's Direct and the Jim Humble stuff and that, I do that when every time I get up to go to the bathroom and I drink lots of water. So I have to get up 5 or 6 times. So I do it 5 or 6 times during the night. I wake up the next day and, you know, pretty much all gone. And then, you know, within 2 days, if I don't have to go out and amongst them again within 30 feet, then I'm good. But if you get within 30 feet, waggity, waggity, it's like, I don't want to be around you guys. Don't shake hands. Thank you. I'll just bow. Like Japanese.
That must be, it's a really weird feeling. It must feel like they're almost sentient, these little parts of AI. I remember Dr. Kerry Madej had shown that, and I was like, these things have a life force basically programmed into them. And it must see you going, yep, we got a live one. Let's go to him.
Yeah, they actually are sentient. The graphene oxide actually has the ability to recreate your genetics into the web, and it's sentient. It seeks out the neural systems, literally coats the DNA in certain in neural areas and all of that and in the genetic structure, and then uploads a virtual you. But in the meantime, it's learning, and it gives you thoughts, feelings, and emotions. That's why I like to keep it out of me. As it was when I was really bad and where I used to be, I had like periodically something, you know, I'd have to do the protocol 1000. I called 1000 plus from Jim Humble mega plus, because I was doing it every half hour, three drops. And it's just like have to, because they try to, you know, they make you crave chips, and I don't even like chips anymore now that I got it out. It was like, you can't eat even just one, you know, it tastes rancid, but it's really kind of, weird how it makes you crave stuff and not like the Jim Humble's protocols. It used to be like I had to give myself a pep rally every half hour to get that down. I was like, yeah, go, G, go, go, go. You can do it. It's like, oh my God, now it's not that bad. And yeah. You know, and then also like every once in a while, I find weird things coming in my head and I'm like, I know my thoughts. That's not me. So they do, and I can see it in others that have had the triple jab. They're changing their behaviors. They're getting very aggressive and very, feisty, you know, where they kind of,
You can't question them on it, too. They get aggressive. I've noticed that in my life, too, just with different family and friends. That's the subtle changes at first. And then they get really recalcitrant if you go, hey, I've got this protocol to show you or something like that. You might just mean well and turns into World War VI. We'll skip the other three. Thank you. It's like that.
Just like that. They went all through the first five and combined them into six.
I went from 0 to 60 in 2 seconds. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. It's that to me is the worst part about it. And that reminds me that, oh, my goodness, to open up with a prayer for today. Would you be happy to do that with me just so we can
absolutely. We don't want to forget that. Yeah, appreciate that. So I'll go ahead and do the invocation and the prayer if that's okay with you.
I'd love that. Thank you so much.
Great. Thank you, Matt. All beings, life forms, thought forms, entities, technologies, beingness, awareness, assemblage, all else that exists, that's not in the highest interest of all life everywhere. In our highest interest and the highest interest of all those living and the highest service to the one and only God of all creation, the living God of all love, light, compassion, and creation, the divine Holy Spirit and his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, demand you to leave this platform, this presentation, this broadcast now or whenever anyone's listening to it forever. All permission to create or maintain attachments, to influence from within or without in any way, to captivate or possess and partner whole effect or defect in any way, permanently now and forever removed. All algorithms, thought forms, genetic overlays, nanodust, smart dust, graphene oxide, operating systems, anything else that is not organic, not made by the one God of all creation in the highest service to the one God of all creation, are now demanded to leave in the word of the one and only God of all creation. All commitments, agreements, contracts, obligations we have made that are not in our highest interest, not in the highest interest of all life everywhere, and in the highest service to the one and only God of all creation, we now declare null and void. All permissions, demands, and are asked for in the name of the one and only God of all creation, living God of all love, light, compassion, creation, his divine Holy Spirit, and in the name of his only begotten Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for allowing us to come together and share your truth and to help the world to wake up to your truth and to the truth of what the minions of Satan are doing here. For nothing that is hidden shall not become known, we know, by the light of your Holy Spirit shining on it. The truth shall be come to light and be known, and all that is hidden that is evil shall be destroyed in your infinite power, of your infinite reach, of your infinite hand. We thank you, and we ask you that you keep our awareness and our truth as your truth, and that we thank you for the gift of your only begotten Son, the infinite gift, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you. And bless all of us God bless and Godspeed. Okay, Matt, you're up.
Okay. I was waiting for the amen. I'll tie it off with the bow. Amen. And thank you very much for that invocation there, Gene. That's wonderful. So if anyone wants to do that every day, just play this back. And there's a wonderful way there to do that with Gene together in a virtual way.
So, I do it every morning and every night when I go to bed, sometimes in my sleep. I'll get up in the, sometimes just slip into the astral plane and the nasties come after you. I go, oh, all these life force. It's like I got it memorized. They can do that asleep.
All of a sudden they go, hey, here, there he is. That guy's back. Let's go. Let's go and have some fun.
Let's go get him. There's Gene Decode. Let's get him. We want to munch on him. He's pissing us off lately.
That's actually a very good question to really kick up on, is that when you're someone as a light being or doing service to God modalities and activities, such as yourself and some of the other people out there that are bravely doing this in the time where the demons are squealing, literally, and you see it come out of people when they are questioned and challenged on their stance on a certain new sci-fi genre, we'll call it. Isn't it incredible? Just how much of that spiritual battle is going on at the moment? And what would you like to say about that as we start?
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, it's incredible. And the sci-fi videos and even the cartoon now on Netflix, there's a new cartoon that's like completely like outing everything about the deep state. It's like, we're in control and we did this. It's a cartoon. They're making believe like it's not real. They're saying everything I've said for like years on there. It's like, wow. This is like, people watch that and go, wow, it sounds like Gene Decode wrote this.
Yes. Oh my goodness. I put it on by accident. I was just in the top 10. I was going, oh, I'll have a look at this.
I'm glad you mentioned top 10 too. Because like in the NASCAR and big stadiums now, they have this chant that they're doing. No president has ever had lower approval rating. 95% of Republicans don't like him. 67% of Democrats, or 37% of Democrats, 67% of liberals. And now in the big stadiums, they're going, you know, I won't say the first word. It starts with an F and ends in a K. People know what I mean. Biden, Biden. So they had it on the news, and a newscaster said, no, they're saying, what is it? Go Branden. So now, you know, what's her name? The gal that, I can't remember her name. She's a big gal, but she has a lot of amazing songs, beautiful songs.
Nothing higher than a
starts
three.
With an A. I can't remember her name now. She did the song for one of the James Bond movies. Oh my goodness, my mind is blank.
No.
Adele, thank you. I knew it started with an A. Thank you, Matt.
Right, like, thanks for the wake-up test, too. Yeah. And, it's about awake.
Yeah. Her song was on the number one on the iTunes. It slipped to number four. went from one to two to three to four. And in the top 10, you know, the top three are different rappers' versions with different words. Let's go, Branden. And then number eight is also Let's Go Branden. Top 10, there four of them are Let's Go Branden.
So when you look at the subtleties and you're living in that vibrant energy, and you can see the humor in what's happening here, I find it fascinating, because I've fallen into the trap of getting angry and antsy about seeing news and gut punches, I call it, when there's like stuff that comes out in the news cycle, whatever, and makes you go, oh my goodness, this is the wagons are circling all of us. Oh no, da da da, and getting in that mental head state. But if you look back at a different perspective, if you look at the news, you realize you can tell what's a white hat operation and what's not so easily now, because it's funny. And I just realized the lighter the vibration, the more fun there is within the message. And then once you see it, it's like a profound change. You just get into fits of laughter when you just see what's going on here. Obviously tragic what is happening to people that have made the wrong decision on certain things, but always trying to remind myself that's a soul contract that some people have already made. But what do you think about that in the sense of humor and that whole conversation?
I think humor, has such a big place. And look at the cognitive dissonance of what's going on. It gets to the point where, and it's a good way to wake people up. I've done it before where you use humor and just, you know, we have a guy in the U.S., they call him Carrot Top. He's kind of a red-haired guy, and it's hilarious. So one, I'll share a little bit of this one. It's really funny.
Oh, please. Love to.
What are you doing? You're to do a little swimming. You got to wear a life jacket or else you can't come in.
No, I'm good. Thank you.
Life jackets are mandatory.
Oh. Mandatory to wear a life jacket when you swim?
And when you're not swimming, too.
Why?
Cases of people getting wet are going through the roof. It's a scary time. Put it on. But that doesn't mean they're drowning. People get wet every day. It's part of life. 0.00001182% of all people drown each year. That's practically everybody. So put on a life jacket. That doesn't make any logical sense. I'm not putting one on. I know how to swim. I've had swimming lessons.
Oh, swimming lessons? Do you think those exist?
So what, you just think your body has this natural ability to traverse through water in a way that keeps your head up so you can still breathe?
Yeah, it's called swimming.
Never heard of it. Flotation devices are backed by science. You don't believe in science?
I do. It's just, I know how to swim.
You're kind of being racist right now.
What?
Look how his life jacket is keeping him from drowning.
He's just standing in shallow water.
Put a life jacket on now. You're putting everyone at risk of drowning.
How am I putting everyone at risk?
Their life jackets won't work unless you have one on.
Does his life jacket work?
Yes, very well.
Then why would he need me to wear a life jacket when his life jacket already works?
We have to protect the protected swimmers from the unprotected swimmers.
But aren't they already protected?
Yes. Very well protected.
So they should be fine.
They would be, except they're not very well protected because of you. Look, you gotta put one on or you can't go in.
This feels creepy. So where would I get one?
Oh, I'm selling them right here.
You're selling life jackets?
Yes,
of course.
So you're demanding that everyone wear a life jacket while you are selling life jackets?
Yes, for their protection.
And they have to buy the life jacket from you?
Indeed.
Don't you think that's a conflict of interest?
No conflict of interest that I can think of.
How much money have you made this year from life jackets?
$27 billion.
Seems like you're more interested in making money than keeping people safe from a...
You're an anti-science, anti-life jacket, climate change denier.
With cases of people getting wet going through the roof, I'm going to need you to buy a life jacket for me and put it on, or else you'll never have access to swimming pools, showers, rain, or drinking water ever again.
You're treating me like I'm the enemy. If you're concerned with people drowning, shouldn't you be treating water like it's the danger instead of treating me like I'm the danger?
Your body's made up of 70% water, so you're basically a ticking time bomb. Put one on.
Buddy, you are the last person I'd want to take direction from. You're so pushy, it's creeping me out.
You're like the Harvey Weinstein of lifeguards.
Thank you.
Oh, look, just today, a man up the road died from drowning in a head-on collision car accident because he wasn't wearing his life jacket.
Wouldn't he have died from a car accident?
A bottle of water was found in the car. Counts as a water death.
That doesn't make any sense.
God works in mysterious ways, and there is no God, so you'll need to obey me.
Oh, my God, he's drowning. Help him.
Sir, please get out of the pool and put this life jacket on.
He can't get out. He's drowning.
Grab the edge of the pool. It's right behind you. Just reach for it.
No.
It's not in the proven method of protection against drowning. It's quite dangerous, actually.
Just grab the edge.
Do not do that. It's unapproved.
For God's sake, just grab the edge.
Can we censor him, please? For your protection, do not grab the edge.
Help me, your lifeguard.
Okay, I will. You should have put a life jacket on while you still had the chance. You're kind of getting what you deserve.
Look what you did to him, you monster.
This never would have happened if you had a life jacket on.
Now put a life jacket on.
Okay.
How about you're fully protected?
Enjoy your swim.
I'll need to see proof that you're wearing a life jacket. Show me your papers.
That's a part of how we are, isn't it?
Wow. Well done, Carrot Top. I mean, that's the pinnacle of his career there.
You hit beautiful, every single detail of the mandates. I was like, oh my God.
I don't know if you could hear me. I was laughing out loud all the way through that.
Everyone, that's how we should all be in our default mode. I know it's hard, but hey, you know, these things just lift our spirits, and that's living in the vibration and the harmony with source creation, and seeing the irony and everything in this modern day, while everything's crazy out there, to remain centered in the eye of the storm is quite a difficult thing to achieve, isn't it? So, I mean, you know, certainly that must be quite a interesting thing where you might come across people that don't have that sense of humor, and they might be into the truth movement especially, and might be very serious. How can people, do you think, tackle maybe some of that? And have you got any suggestions for ways we can all look within ourselves and get right with God and source energy kind of thing?
Precisely. It's getting right with God in Christ. And then, you know, if they're not awake, they're awake, but to some degree, I share some information that will help turn them away from like being overwhelmed and cynical, to have an understanding that through God, everything is possible. So we will get through this, and it's going to, you know, be a Red Sea moment. It's going to be a near-death experience, like 107 says all the time. You know, it will likely get tough. You know, it gets that way for this time, for, you know, the humanity to wake up to the what has been done for thousands of years. It has to get to the really hard level. When it does that, it gets into the genetics. So, you know, for example, the mask mandates are tied to the agenetic memory. That's why they're enforcing them, not because they work, because they or don't. I just say that I'm not a licensed medical professional, right? So you don't attack me, but, you know, I have my own point of view and understanding and research, you know, and the microns and understanding of the filtration levels and all that. So, but it ties to a memory in the genetics that in the old slaving days, they had a mask that went over the face, a muzzle more like, with a bar over the head, and it, that then clipped to a ring around the neck. And that genetic memory ties us to that, so that when they force this, it's enforcing the memory that, you know, they want us to have, that we are their slaves, that, you know, like 2,000 years ago, you were either a slave, an indentured servant. Very few people were truly free at all, except for the big wealthy ones, you know, the one percenters. And that's pretty much what they're trying to reinforce now to us. And, you know, so that they can get us back in that thought stream and that thought mode. And so we need to step out beyond that and create a new genetic memory. And so that's what Scott's doing, is, you know, this will be a genetic memory, so that after this cabal is taken out, there won't be another one coming back, because people will forever remember what happened and what it, you know, when all of what has happened comes out, it'll be an indelibly etched in the genetics itself of the human race. So they will never permit this to happen again.
That is brilliantly said there, Gene. I certainly have that same position as well, in the sense of how I see it, and, you know, through my learning curve, because I'm perfectly imperfect, as we all are, in a human meat suit. We have to go and forgive ourselves for certain days and things like that when we might be out of alignment. But certainly what you're saying there is quite profound, because we have a choice ultimately through this, don't we? I mean, it doesn't matter what our, and I remind everyone that the word government even has govern man, and then it's got a little black magic in it to set that intention. So our English language is mired with that. And as people slowly are starting to awaken now, it's almost like there's this concerted effort to wake people up by making the mandate so extreme that it's like, come on, see the light here. And some people just remain fast asleep and can't see it. It's just a really interesting duality kind of moment we're in. And, yeah, so I'll try and keep my questions as short as possible to sort of keep things moving along there. But, yeah, I find that the most profound part all about this, but the most enlightening work I've done to get right with God has been in the last 6 months to a year especially. I'd say the bell curve has gone right up in that direction. And have you noticed that too, where some people are really, really having manifestation and beautiful things happen, awakening within themselves, and how they behave around others is just shifting into a beautiful way, and then you got some others that become recalcitrant through all of this. What's your sort of take on that, and how do you think it's going to impact the timeline?
Well, you know, first, I tell people to realize that they always tell you Satanism requires the course of heaven require the Satanists to tell the world what they're doing beforehand. It's what they call disclosure in a court case. So, you know, it's been going on for a long time where they disclose what they're going to do beforehand. So, if, you know, for example, this was DIA in 1994 mural in Denver International Airport.
Oh, wow. And
there's a bat.
That place freaked me out.
Yeah. And so then even further back, I mean, they project things so far back. I mean, I remember these type of videos when I was in elementary school. This is 1956.
When you think of the future, you likely envision the remarkable technologies that you've seen in comic books and films. You may begin to picture flying cars, trains driven by electromagnets, or household robots that will see to your every need. While modern scientists agree that many of these inventions are either unlikely or unnecessary, it may surprise you to learn what the future could actually hold. Imagine being able to share your thoughts with millions of people at once, simply by typing them on a keyboard and sending them through the air. Think of what life will be like when all of the many fixtures of an office, including a typewriter and an entire Rolodex, can fit within a device smaller than a loaf of bread. Consider the vacation plans you could make when a single trip on an airplane is all that's needed to visit anywhere on Earth. Yes, the future certainly looks bright, but it isn't without its darker sides. According to some predictions, obesity will likely run rampant, and political corruption will become so commonplace as to be accepted. People with nothing entertaining or informative to say will broadcast their demands for attention, and once beloved performers will become pushers of snake oil. Perhaps worst of all will be the emergence of a deadly and potentially devastating disease. Think of the last time that you contracted influenza. You were likely bedridden for days, having no appetite or desire to play games. Experts predict that by the year 2020, a new virus will rise, spreading from somewhere in Asia to the rest of the world. And with international travel being available to even the most common citizen, a sickness which would have been contained in years past will quickly spread to all corners of the globe.
See how they put that out? They're putting that in the, it's envisioning. They're creating the mind to envision that scenario, and they're doing, you know, long-range projection of what they're going to do. That's discovery in a court case. They went to God's court and said, yeah, that's what we're going to do. So, you know, in keeping up hope and understanding the difference that we can all make, somebody sent me this beautiful video about this one gentleman.
Would you stand up, please?
We can all make a difference in, you know, helping others and standing up for the truth and doing what we know to be right. And so it is profound what one person can do if you just stand up and take the chance and take the risk and get out there and do what you know to be right. It'll make the difference. Could even mean life or death for, like in that person's case, 660 plus people.
Wow. You can't make this stuff up. I'm looking at it going, wow, how could anyone not wake up after seeing that? It's not like someone created it in the modern day and just trying to punk everyone. That's legitimate. And certainly if that's not going to wake anyone up, then I don't know what we can do. It's like, that's
in
your face.
I mean, it's the way they cover it, you know, in the future, bigger, smaller than a bread box. Yeah, something you can put in the palm of your hand called an iPhone. Right? You can fly around the world on vacation in one plane. You know, you can do that. And they showed that computer and they have all that blueprint and the guy's wiring the computer. Like, I was like, yeah, this is like really definitely. My dad worked at, like, you know, and Mark married one just like that with big, huge 14-inch reels. It was 16-inch watts. It didn't even do what my iPad could do. I'm like, ah, yeah, that's exactly how it was. For sure. I was like, wow.
Like a 70s spy movie, if you ever watch them, the big tape rooms and stuff like that, a computer would take up literally the size of a single-story home. very funny. But there's a show I watched, and I stumbled across this by accident, called Not the 9 O'Clock News. It's a UK show from the late 60s, early 70s. And there's a scene in there, and I found it, and the guy was holding an iPhone. And then next is Rowan Atkinson doing a speech about the future, what it's going to look like. And he's standing in front of the TV audience going, this is the way it's going to be, blah, blah, blah. I was blown out. It's unbelievable what sort of cues they planned into our collective consciousness to direct the timeline with that conjuring of magic. Do you think there's a kind of a process and that's how they do it? And the more we kind of talk about it, the less power it has, because we allow people a chance to see through programming.
Exactly. When you show the ridiculousness of it, you show the cognitive dissonance of it, it takes the power away from it. It starts to put holes in the program, literally. It's like taking a chair leg out, where now the chair is, you know, you have three legs and it's kind of wobbly, and you start cutting pieces off of the other, or you'd even just start cutting pieces off of a leg here and a leg there, and the chair gets all wobbly. It's no longer a stable platform. Their platform is getting holes. It's like that, let's go Biden, you know, let's go Branden. It's like, it's pretty obvious your platform's got serious holes and leaks in it.
What about the elevator pitch he had, we'll say, quote unquote, the other day at the G20, when he apologized for being late? He said, we've been riding up and down elevators. It's a long story. Reminded me of Lloyd Bridges from Hot Shots. It was just... make this up. This is just unbelievable. And it's one of those things where people like yourself, I'm sure, would be just looking at it and probably spending time with your wife laughing your head off at some of the stupidity that people are buying and eating up.
Yep, absolutely. I mean, I go out and, like, so many people got, you know, one or two or three face diapers on. I'm like, and they're driving in their car and they're alone. I'm like, do you live alone and you wear a condom to bed too? What in the world is in your head? You're in a
not very much.
And it's cold as heck outside. I know you got it on recirc. You don't even have air coming in.
Exactly. They're going to get hypoxia. They get dumber and dumber.
Yeah. It's astounding. Getting, dumber and dumbest, right? It's like, oh, my goodness.
Well, yeah, Living Idiocracy, the movie from 06, that movie just summed it up. It's just incredible what's happening.
My dogs, when it first started happening, go to the dog park, and they're looking at me, and they go, how come the people are dumber than I am? What are they doing wearing muzzles? Are they biting each other?
The thoughts of a dog perspective, hey, that's true. I think that.
Yeah, the dog is looking
at me. Why don't you have one, Daddy?
What is there, some kind of rabid thing going with humans? Everybody's biting each other? I'm sure glad you don't have that. I'm going to get worried if you wear a muzzle.
Exactly. That would be fantastic, little documentary in a dog's world, how they would be seeing what we're doing from their perspective. Get a voiceover, like Scooby-Doo type voiceover to narrate. But, yeah, that whole thing actually, it's an interesting point you brought up there, because what I've extrapolated is through all of this, there's a lot of zombie apocalypse programming that's been going on for the last 5 years. So let's unthread that one and send it to the divine court to get it demolished. We don't want that happening. Uganda, that test that happened. I think you mentioned that in some of your interviews too, and how they can activate certain frequencies to make people go rabid.
Oh, absolutely. It's, you know, in there. That's part of what the programming for this stuff is.